and welcome to Faith and Yoga at St. Bartholomew's. I'm Dixie, and I'm here with my husband Fred, Aaron Porter, and Glenn Gobrick to bring to you today's yoga practice. We're still focusing on connecting with our heart. Well, this week we're focusing on working our heart. So we want to connect to find love and joy in our work that we can do with our heart. And we also want to physically kick up our heart rate a little bit. So we're going to have a little more of an active yoga practice today. I'd like to open with a prayer. This prayer is from the New Zealand prayer book, and it's, O God of peace and justice, of holiness and love, knit us together in mind and flesh, in feeling and in spirit, and make us one, ready for a great day. Well, I hope you're ready for a great day and starting it off with some yoga. We're going to start by feeling our heart. So put your hand over your heart. You can put it right in the heart center, or maybe you need to go to the left a little bit. And if you're comfortable with closing your eyes for a moment or so, please do. Maybe you can concentrate a little bit better on feeling that beat. So take a moment, thinking about love and joy, focusing on your heart's beat. This week, one of the featured entertainers on Good Morning America was Amy Grant. And when I was younger and my kids were growing up, I spent a lot of time having Amy Grant playing in the background for motivation and just her beat. Well, we came to find out that Amy just recently, about 6 months ago, had heart surgery from a birth defect in her heart she knew nothing about. And one of her famous songs was Every Heartbeat Depends on You. I don't know if you know that song or not, but that's a very good song to listen to, and it reminds us of who set the heartbeat in our chest for each and every one of us. So that was just something I wanted to bring forth today. The other thing is the music in the background is the harp guitar music that I was speaking about last week. So I hope you enjoy listening to that as well. Go get your heart shapes, and we're going to start with some breathing. Remember what I said, if you don't have a heart at home, you can take a moment just to draw a heart shape on a piece of paper. And we're going to do our breathing in for four, starting at the center of the heart, coming down to the point with a pause, and then coming back up for the completion. So when you're ready, let's breathe in through the nose for a count of four. One, two, three, and four, with a pause. Exhaling through the nose, four, three, two, one. At the center again. Breathing in, one, two, three, four, at the point, pause, coming back around, four, three, two, one. Two more times around, friends. Breathe in, one, two, three, and four, and exhale, four, three, two, one. One more time. One, two, three, four, with a pause, and exhale, four, three, two, one. Don't put your hearts too far away. We're going to be using them for some of our yoga moves / cardio exercising today, so keep them close by. As always, I found some wonderful Bible verses to relate to today's class. And before we do that, Fred, would you give us the chime that gives us our official start? And we'll start, Fred, if you don't mind coming up with your Bible verse.
Mm-hmm. My verse is from Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 16. When your words came, I ate them. They were my joy and my heart's delight. I know sometimes in life, the words don't come. When they do come, sometimes we wish we could eat them because sometimes we say the wrong thing. Every now and then I get inspired to write something poetic, and it seems like when that happens, the right words come at the right time, so I'm able to digest them and put them down on paper, which is a blessing. Thank you.
Thanks, Fred. Glenn, would you be ready to come up next?
My Bible verse is 1 John chapter 3, verse 1 through 6, or a synopsis thereof. See what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. And I had to ponder over this. If I'm going to spread lavishly amounts of good things out on people, it's probably my family first, my children, before I think about the neighbors. But God lavished His love and goodness out on all of us who believe in Him as our Lord. And that's my take on this verse today.
Wonderful explanation, Glenn. And Aaron, would you come up, please?
My verse is from Psalms chapter 63, verse 3. Because your love is better than life, my lips will glorify you.
Thank you, Erin. Well, let's get started with today's warm-up. So, as I said, we're going to need our hearts. So we're going to start with having our heart in our hand here. And I'll show you first what I'd like you to do. And I'm going to take off my mask so you can hear me a little better. I forgot I had it on. So I'd like you to stand about hips width apart, maybe a little bit more. And I want you to hold your heart in your right hand. And we're going to bend our knees and reach our heart up towards the sky to the right side. Then we're going to bring it down to the center. Switch over to the left hand, do a little bend with the left knee, and a stretch out to the side. My yoga students have it right here. So bend out, and to the center, and left, and to the center. This time, really reach and point that left toe out. Back into the center, a bend to the other side. Now we got it going, so we're going to go a little faster. Here we go. Let's go. And a little faster if you can, without losing your form. And a little faster if you can. Remember to be happy. A happy heart is a healthy heart. Can you go a little faster? Slow it down. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. And let's put our hands on our heart now. Is that heart beating a little bit faster than it was before? I'm getting some nods and maybe a little bit faster. Good. So that's one way you can use your heart for cardio. While we're at it, we're going to do some twists here. So hold your heart in front of you. This is what we're going to do. We're going to do this kind of swing to the right, back to the center, and then to the left. And once again, doing the old hand switch here. Center. And go ahead. Keep up with this pace. We got it warmed up, we'll go a little faster. remember. This is fun. And if you can pick up your pace a little, swing it over. The other side. The other side. Back. Over. Back. And a little faster. And a little faster. Now bringing it back to a medium. And then at your own pace, slowing it down to where you're comfortable. And it's easy beasy. Okay. Okay. And then just bring your heart to your center. The other thing we're going to do is we're just going to lift this heart overhead. If you're comfortable leaning back without putting support on your back, go ahead and just let yourself open up and lean back. This is a heart opener and the back bend. And let yourself come back to center. And just for right now, I'm going to put my heart down. You can put yours down too. And we're going to come to a mountain pose. So with mountain pose, we're going to stand tall. And our hands are going to be here beside us, like this. Think of your head, a string being attached to the crown of your head. So you're standing nice and tall. And legs are strong. So from here, we are going to actually bring our hands behind us and interlace your fingers. This is another heart opener. And let your shoulders pull down behind you here. Yes, how does that feel? Yeah, we haven't done that for a while. Now I'm going to ask you to let your knees bend and come forward and lift those arms up into kind of a forward fold. Bring your head down towards your knees if you're comfortable with that. And bring yourself back up again. And release those hands. And give them a shake out. And now we're just going to put our hands kind of beside us like a bird flying almost. And then just push them back behind us like that. That uses some other muscles in our arms that we haven't been using too often. And then once again, let your knees bend. And let yourself sit back a little bit. This kind of engages more of a leg muscle with the arms. And let yourself come back forward. Hands to heart center. Good job, everyone. That was some good moves and some cardio help with a little bit of inversion there. So we got all warmed up. It's kind of chilly in here. So we're going to come to the mat now, and I'll meet you in tabletop. So in tabletop position, your hands are spread wide and open like starfish. Knees are hip distance apart. You should be able to look back and not see your toes. So we're going to go ahead and get started with some cat and cows. We'll start with cow. So inhale, belly drops, gaze looks up. Let's exhale. Let's curl our spine and lift it up. Inhale, belly drops, gaze looks up. And exhale, spine rises up. And let yourself come to neutral position here. We're going to do our spinal balance. So we're going to send our right hand out, left leg goes back, toes point down. Nice and strong here. Bring that back in. We're going to send the left hand out, right leg
back, toes pointed down. And bring it back in. For right now, we're going to tuck our toes and walk our hands back and just give a little stretch there of the toes and the arch there. And just let that stretch for just a moment. Just gently rocking back here. And then we're going to come back down to the tabletop position. And we're going to wag our dog here a little bit. Just loosen up your hips from side to side. And while we're doing dogs, we might as well do our pointer dog. So once again, right arm goes out, left leg goes back. When you feel you're strong with your balance, swing that right hand over to the left corner of your mat in a diagonal. And then back to center and down. Once again, do a little bit of the wag the dog again. And back to center, left hand goes out, right foot goes back, and a diagonal across. And back to center. Knees comes back to tabletop, and let's do a child's pose here. Big toes come together, thighs are apart, and let yourself go down for a child's pose. Breathing in and out here, breathe in for four, and out for four. In for four, and exhale out. Let your fingers rise up as you breathe in the next one, as if they were hovering over a bowl of Cheerios here. Good for your heart. And exhale, let your hands come down. Walk your left hand over to the left corner of your mat. Put your right hand on top. And breathe into a C curve on that side. Coming back to center. Once again, up with the fingertips. And let yourself come down. And then over to the right. Right hand and your C curve going toward the right this time. And letting yourself return to center and back up to tabletop. We're gonna do our thread the needle. So when you're ready, let that right arm go out. We're gonna bring it back down. We're gonna let the left arm go up and bring that down. This time, right arm comes up a little higher and we put it through that space that the left arm provides and give your shoulder a good stretch. Pushing up with that left hand, allowing your arm to come back through. Giving yourself a little wag the dog again. Left arm goes up a little higher than before and goes through that space provided with the right arm. One more breath here. And pushing up with that right hand and arm unwinds. We're going to get our kickstand ready here. We're going to put our right foot out for our kickstand. And we're going to open that right arm up towards the sky. Open up that chest.
and stretch it back a little farther if you can. Breathing in and out. The next exhale, you can bring that down and switch to the other side. And open that arm up. And we're back. We're gonna tuck our toes for our first down dog here. So tuck your toes, and when you're ready, let's do the down dog. Hips should be high. Once again, this is an inversion. The heart's higher than the head right now. So let yourself pedal in and out here, filling the strength. And also, let's wag our dog here a little bit. That works some muscles that we don't use as often. Also, three more wags here. One, two, and three. And once again, get strong in those arms. And we're going to walk forward here. And meet in the center. And let yourselves come up. Good job. Thinking about how different it feels to be up than it does inverted. I saw some people coming up a little slower, which is a good idea. One vertebrae at a time, if you can, is always a good idea. We're back here in mountaintop position. And from here, we're going to bring our fingertips to our shoulders. And this is what we're going to do. We're going to sweep in like we're making the shape of a heart, bringing them in and then back down to center. So breathe in, lift up, and then back down. Deep breath in as you lift, lift, and exhale down. Good job. Let's do five more. One, two, three, four. Good job. Shake those arms out because they're going to be a little tired. The other thing we're going to do is hands to heart center here. And if you would like to do this, we can make the shape of the heart. Put it here. And then lift that heart overhead. Hands are up almost like they'd be interlaced. We do that sometimes. And take a bend to the right. Coming back up to center. And taking a bend to the left. Up to center. Leaning back. Coming back up to center. Taking it down for another forward fold. Letting your head hang heavy. Shake your head yes. Shake your head no. And with intention, on one vertebrae at a time, lift back up, and I'll meet you standing with your heart shape at your heart center. So when you're ready, lift up. Nice to see that. Good job. And let your hands come free. And just give them a good shake here. We're going to go to pyramid position. So we're going to take the right leg out. Point it so it's straight out here. The left leg is facing the front of your mat. Take an inhale and let your leg, your arm trace down your leg. And left arm comes up. Breathing in and out here. Inhale, let yourself come back up. Meeting at center. Readjust your legs so that right foot is parallel with the back of the mat, and the left foot is pointed forward. And once again, left hand goes down that left leg, right arm comes up. And back down. And meet together in center. We're going to do a little bit of a balance here of a tree. But what pose we're going to do with our hands is we're going to do like a heart tree. So your hands will stay here at heart center when you have your balance, and then when you're ready, just let them go up and then bring back down. So ground into your left foot. Whatever is most comfortable for you, don't forget to have your focal point. You can do your ankle, your calf. Just keep your focal point strong. Hands to heart center here. Breathing in and out. When you're ready, you can let your tree grow. Good job. And then you can bring it back to heart center. And replace that foot. Give your feet a little bit of a shake out here. Ground into that right foot. Left foot comes to its comfortable position for your tree. Find your focal point. Heart's ready at the center. And when you're ready, let your heart grow. Good job. Don't be afraid of falling. It's okay. The mat's always there. And one side might be easier than the other to do. And when you're ready, bring yourself back. Good job. We're going to come to our heart chair. So just grab your heart again. And let yourself come back a little bit. Feet are about hip distance apart, not quite that wide. And let yourself sit back. Bring your heart up in that fierce position. Being strong in those calves and those knees. Breathe in for four. And out, and in, and out, and one more breath in, and out for four, and let yourself come back up. Good. Good job. We're also going to let our arms come out to the side, and we're going to do the embrace hug, so cross them over in the center. Pay attention to which hand's on top. When you're out here, switch hands with your heart. Out it goes. And across. And out it goes. And across. And open. And across. Good job, everyone. All right, we're going to come down and join again in the down dog. So you can take a forward fold and meet me here in down dog. Once again, we're going to pedal it out a little. And kind of move our hips from side to side. And let yourself maybe go forward and back. And when you're ready, let yourself come down to a high plank here. And just hold. Remember to breathe. If you need to come to your knees, please do. And from high plank, let yourself come to your knees. And let yourself come down to your belly. Your heart in front of you. You can put it down in your center so it would be centered with your nose. And just take a moment here to breathe in and maybe reflect on some of the scriptures that were read. Remembering to have fun with this yoga practice. Thinking about how it's working our heart and how the heartbeat was put there by God for us.
And a healthy heart is a happy heart. So with your nose, kind of push it toward that heart, bringing your torso up, looking to the right, looking to the center, and looking to the left. And back to center. And let yourself come back to it. We're going to push back into child's pose again for just a moment. Letting yourself take a break. And get a drink if you need a little bit of water. Going to show us the starfish plank. Again, we're going to continue to work on that, and then we'll work on our extended side planks. So make sure you don't want to miss that. And then we'll do our cool down and savasana. So come on up, Fred.
Week when we did this pose, I think I had you start out in tabletop position, but I think today we're going to do it a little bit differently. We're actually going to start out in a more of a plank pose or a cobra pose, and then we'll roll over to one side. Another thing I didn't use last week was a block, so I brought my block along today, and I'll show you how to maybe put a little more safety in this position with a little less stress than what we had last week, because I think last week was kind of a workout for at least myself. I don't know about other people, but I had trouble with that. So we're going to start out the plank, go down to a cobra, and then we'll just roll to one side, get our elbow underneath us. And if you have a block, or if you don't have a block, we'll still do the pose, but put that block under your hip, which will kind of take some of the stress off of that part of your body. And then when you're ready, you can raise that right leg up. Bring your right arm up over your head. You'll also put your hand on your stomach in this position, or you can put it behind your back. And another thing you can do with this pose, you can actually lengthen your left leg, put your right foot on top of it, just like a regular side plank. And then another variation, you could actually go to tree pose from here. Bring your right leg up to your calf.